Hello, in today's video, we shall learn in detail about genus Piziza belonging to class Ascomycetes. By the end of this video, you will have a clear understanding about its different modes of reproduction and its life cycle pattern. Let us start with the general characteristics of Discomycetes. Members of this group are called the cup fungi. The Discomycetes are saprophytic, which grow on dung, decaying or burnt wood, or on richly manured soil. They show the presence of cup or saucer-shaped fleshy ascocarp known as apothecium. In most of the Discomycetes, the ascocarps are above ground. They are called epigene. The ascocarps are open, club-shaped, arranged in palisade-like layer on the surface or in open cavities. They show the presence of sterile hyphae paraphyses, which occur intermingled with the asci. Members of Discomycetes show gradual and progressive reduction in sexuality. Sexual process is simple, showing union of two vegetative nuclei in a pair. Let us take up genus Piziza as an example and study about it in detail. It belongs to class Ascomycetes, order Pizizales, family Pizizaceae. Piziza vesiculosa is a saprophytic Discomycetes, generally growing in soils rich in organic matter or on decaying wood. They are often coprophilous in habit. The mycelium is well developed, showing dense network of hyphae. The hyphae are branched extensively within the substratum and are septate. The cells are uninucleate. The fruiting bodies are above ground. Asexual reproduction in genus Piziza takes place by the formation of non-motile spores, namely conidia and chlamydospores. Conidia are exogenously formed spores found on the tips of conidiophore. Each conidium is capable of germinating into a new mycelium. Chlamydospores are resting spores. They are thick-walled and intercalary in position. They may be formed singly or in chains. Under suitable conditions, each chlamydospore can germinate and give rise to a new mycelium. By the way, if you're getting some value out of this video, please like and share the video so that all of us can learn, unlearn, and relearn together. Also, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Now, we shall learn about the sexual reproduction in genus Piziza. The sexual apparatus is lacking in Piziza vesiculosa. The sexual process is extremely simplified. Somatic copulation occurs between certain vegetative cells at the time of reproduction. The dikaryotic condition, that is, pairing of nuclei to form dikaryons, is brought about either by autogamous pairing or by somatogamous copulation between the vegetative cells of adjacent hyphae. These cells give rise to the ascogenous hyphae. Formation of septa results in multicellular binucleate cells. The terminal binucleate cells of the ascogenous hyphae function directly as ascus mother cells. The ascogenous hyphae, the dikaryotic cells from which they are developed, and the binucleate ascus mother cells constitute the dikaryophase in the life cycle. The two nuclei in the ascus mother cell fuse to form the synchorion. The young ascus with a synchorion represents the transitory diplophase. The synchorion undergoes three successive divisions. The first two constitute meiosis, resulting in the formation of 8 haploid nuclei. The resultant haploid nuclei get organized into 8 ascospores in the mature ascus. The single-celled uninucleate ascospores are oval or spherical in shape. Next, we shall look into the structure of apothecium. The fruit body is an apothecium with a fleshy, sessile or subsessile cup or saucer-shaped body. The fruiting bodies are always above ground. Vertical section through the apothecium shows the upper surface known as hymenium with elongated cells lying at right angles to the surface. It consists of erect acini intermingled with sterile protective hyphae called paraphysis. Below the hymenium is a layer known as hypothecium running parallel to the surface of the hymenium. The basal part of the cup is known as accipulum. The acini near the margin of the cup bend towards the source of light since they are positively phototropic. The acini are club-shaped with a lid-like operculum hinged at the apex. The top portion of mature acini project above the level of hymenium. The lid of the ascus opens the apical pore and the ascospores explode. The ascospores on germination produce a new septate mycelium. The graphic representation of the life cycle of Pisiza clearly shows three distinct phases, namely the dikaryophase, the diplophase, and the haplophase. The dikaryophase is represented by the dikaryotic cell, ascogenous hyphae, and the ascus mother cell. This is followed by karyogamy. The young ascus with the synchorion represents the transitory diplophase. With the successive division of the synchorion, haploid ascospores are formed, which on germination forms the new mycelium. This is the haplophase in the life cycle of Pisiza. So today, we have learnt in detail about genus Pisiza, its mode of reproduction, and its life cycle pattern. I have some practice questions for you. Please share your answers in the comment section below. You can pause the video and write down the questions if you like. Thank you so much for your time and participation. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, Please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Also, if you want to discuss any particular topic in biology, please mention that in the comments section below. I'll see you there. Goodbye. All the best.